Hi, hallo, Zdrasien, bonjour, here's a lesson with the first technical detail of Factorio. In this series I will be going over many if not all of the technical details in Factorio and will try my best to explain all of them, including most of the numbers involved. To start off, I want to discuss circuit networks, specifically red and green wires and what they do and how they do it. First of all, we want to know how to connect buildings using the red wire. For this, you simply choose your building you want to start a connection from and left-click on it. This will start the connection using this red wire, which is drawn up to my cursor. You now can choose the second building, but this is not allowed to be too far away. This has a range. If you go out of this range, your cursor will change to a red circle with an X on it. So be sure that the second building is well within reach. Now that I want to use this spell here, so I hover over it and now I left click again, and this will complete the connection. You may notice that I again have a wire starting from the second belt, and this is just a quality of life feature which allows me to connect the next building immediately after without having to click again on this one. If I don't want to do this, I can abort my disconnection by simply pressing Q. This will not drop my stack, but instead abort the connection. If I now want to drop the stack, I simply press Q again. Now these two belts are connected, and I may want to disconnect them again. And for this, I again take my red wire, and I can disconnect this. I can remove this wire the same way I created it. I click on the first building and then I click on the second, and this will remove the wire. Note that the order is not important, so I also could have clicked on this building here first and then on that one. So, the green wire works exactly like the red one. You can remove connections and you can create them. So, you may have already noticed that something funny happens if I hover over a building that is connected to a wire, and that is that the wire highlights. And this happens for the red and the green wire as well, and this is to indicate all the wire that is connected to this building here. So for example, I have here four power poles, and these two power poles to the left are connected by a red wire, and if I hover over one of them, then the wire will highlight. These two are connected by an electrical wire which doesn't highlight, and this is to show that the connection is only for this red wire. Similarly, here only the green wire connects these two, and so only the green wire highlights. Now, I can also, of course, connect more than two buildings together. For example, here I have connected four buildings together, a belt, an inserter, a chest, and a large power pole. The same is true for green wires. We can connect multiple buildings together. So, then you may ask, well, what does this mean? Why do we do this? And to explain this, I first need to introduce you a nice feature about these networks, and that is that each network has associated with it a unique number. To get to know this number, you simply click on any building that is connected to this network, for example on this chest. This opens the chest GUI, and you may notice that now there is this extra tab in there. And there is this number here, and that's this unique number I talked of just a moment ago. In this case, it's 14. And this inserter here has also the same number 14, which means that these two buildings are connected by this red wire, which comprises the network 14. The same is true for the green wires as well. Each network has a unique number. Here it's the number 15, and this also is the same here, and the fact that the number 15 and 14 are not the same is to say that these two networks are distinct. If I go, for example, back up here and look what's the network number here, it's 39. So this red network is not the same as this one. Now you may ask, what will happen if I disconnect two networks? And that's what I have done here. I have four belts that are all connected, and all of them have the network number 21. So they are all connected to the same network, which is this red wire here. Now, if I disconnect them such that there are two networks remaining, then you might expect that they will split up into networks. And lo and behold, this is exactly what happens. The left one stays at the number 21, while the right one jumps to another number 14. These numbers have no other significance than to tell you whether or not two networks are the same or not. You may also ask, well, what happens if I have two networks and I connect them up? And the answer is they will merge. So, for example, we have here a network number 14 and here a network number 21. If I now connect them up, then you will notice this stays at 40 and this one becomes 40 as well. So they are all equal again. You may now ask, well, why do we want to have two different wires then if they are completely the same? For this, you may need to know that the green wires also split up and merge exactly the same. And the answer is, maybe we don't want networks to merge. For example, what if we want to have this belt connected to the chest and the chest also connected to this belt, but not the belts to each other? And that's where we use different colors of wire, so that because they don't merge together. So if I hover over this belt, then you will see that only this green wire highlights, meaning that this belt is really only connected to the chest. Well, if I hover over this belt, then only the red wire highlights, meaning that this belt is only connected to the chest too. I can also check this fact by looking at the numbers, which is here the number 22, indicating that this is network number 22, this red wire here, and this green wire right there is the number 23. So we have two different networks, but if we look at the chest and if we hover over it, then you may notice that both of the wires highlight, meaning that this chest is connected to both networks. And if we open the chest, we will indeed see two entries with the numbers 22 and 23, indicating that this chest is indeed connected to both of these networks. So now that you know that how wires connect different buildings, you may ask yourself, well, why would we want to do that? And to explain this, I need to explain you a very basic fact about Factorio, and that is, it's not a fluent simulation, but instead it's a discrete simulation. This means that instead of trying to do something fancy, Factorio divides up the whole time into each, or it divides up each second into 60 parts. Each part is called a tick or an update, and during that time Factorio takes the whole world and updates everything in it, and then proceeds to the next tick and does the same thing over and over again. And because 60 times per second is rather fast, it seems like everything is fluent fast, but it is in fact not. To demonstrate this fact, I have wired up two lamps here to blink as rapidly as they can once I turn on this switch here. Now they are blinking, and you may notice that in the video it looks like they are not blinking consistently, but rather randomly, and that's because they are blinking too fast for my video card, and so it somehow doesn't seem consistent. But if I slow down the game to 1/60th of its speed, such as one tick becomes 1 second, like this, then you will see that the blinking is perfectly regular and they're just flipping back and forth. And if I now start counting the seconds, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you see that indeed each tick takes exactly 1 second and 1 second only. Now if we speed back up to 60 times the speed, this means we have an update speed of 60 ticks per second. Now let me turn the blinking off again and return to the wires and circuit networks. To understand what they do, it's best to just try to understand what the game engine does. And for this, we only need to know that the game engine doesn't know what happened in the long past or will happen in the long future. It only knows what it has right now. So the whole world is compromise of certain information, and this information changes each update. So to understand how something works means that we only need to know what information is contained in something and how this information changes each tick. So let us try to understand what information is associated with these green and red wires. And the answer for that is a little bit complex. For this, you may open your crafting menu, and you see that you have many item stacks there. And these item stacks, each of them, or item types, for each of those, there is an associated number on every wire. This means that this green wire has a number for each of all of these stacks, or for all of these item types. Most of these numbers are zero, and we can change them, and it's rather hard to imagine, and that's why there is a special feature, and this special feature hovers around power poles. If I hover around a power pole which is not connected to any wire, then you may see in the top right here that there is in line electricity with an empty bar because there's nothing connected to this pole. But if I now hover over an bar over an electric pole which has a signal connected or a circuit wire connected to it, then you will see that there is a new line called signals, and there a bunch of item types are listed: the blue belts, the steel X, and iron plates. And each of them has an associated number. This number is 40 for the belts, 1 for the steel X, and negative 15 for the iron plates. You may also notice that there is a new item type. It's a letter T, with the and the number associated with it is 7. And this is a signal. It's called as a virtual signal, or you may imagine as it as a virtual item type. I call them mostly control signals, and they are just signals that are not associated with any item type. There are many of those. In fact, here are they are all. For each letter and each number, there is one, and a bunch of colors have them too. So, now you may ask, well, you just said that each item type has its own number, but why are there only four numbers displayed here? And the answer for that is that most of these numbers are currently zero on this green wire. And to avoid having to clutter this whole screen with a bunch of zeros, power poles only show non-zero signals. So, for example, the copper plate signal is there, but it has a value 0 and is therefore not displayed. You may also notice that all these signals, all these item stacks or item types, they are drawn over a green rectangle. And this is to indicate that they come from a green network wire. If I have, for example, a red wire with a bunch of signals on them, then they will instead be drawn in red. And here you will also see another feature, and that is that long numbers, like for example the plastic signal with a value of 1000, gets shortened to only the first few digits. This doesn't mean that the value itself is only these first few digits. The value itself is the full number. It's only the display that gets shortened here. So if you sometimes see some large signal that isn't changing, that doesn't mean it's changing. For example, this signal could be changing at around between 1000 and 1010, for example, and because I don't see the last two digits, I wouldn't notice here. So, and that's everything about the information on these wires. So that's the first half that we understood. The second half is now, how are these values changing? And that's also not that complex. What happens is that each network has a bunch of buildings that are connected to it. What then happens each update, or what you can think is happening each update, is that all the values on this wire are sent to all the buildings. These buildings, and then these values are forgotten completely. The wire doesn't remember them anymore. But now the buildings have these values, and they can do things with them. Each building can do its own things, and this is part of another tutorial that's coming soon. But at the end, all of the buildings then return some values. And all these values are then summed up, and these sums are then transferred to the wire, and that's the new wire for this that's a new value for this wire network. So, for example, I have here set up a circular belt, and on there are iron and copper plates. And I have wired up this belt, and we can just look at what this belt is saying happens, or what are the signals that are coming off of it. And you may notice there's mostly nothing, it blinks, and this means that mostly these signals are zero, and sometimes blinks within one of an iron plate or a copper plate. And to see this better, I will again slow down the game, like so, and we will now see that, yes, the signal is mostly empty, and that's what we expect because there's nothing on the belt. But watch what happens when the iron plate crosses the yellow line. There is a signal, a brief signal of one, and now a copper signal of one, that then immediately vanishes. And I want you to notice how long this takes. If the iron plates now again cross, it will take exactly 1 second until it vanishes. And I have the speed set to exactly one update per second. And this means that this belt is sending its signal only once. And the signal is then lost because this wire forgets every value each tick. They need to be resent by the buildings. And that's it. That's how all the values change, and there are only two things to note. The first is what happens if you have a building connected to both networks, to both a green and a red one, for example this chest. And the answer is that the values of the red network and the values of the green network are taken together, summed up, and this sum is then sent to the chest. The chest does then its thing, and its return value is then copied to the green wire and the red wire simultaneously. And that's it. Now you know everything there is to know about the red and green wire. And a last technical detail on performance, which may be important to you if you're planning on using these things a lot. And that is, I just explained how you can think of it working, and that sounded rather complex. And complex things are usually also complex to calculate. And you may wonder, well, what happens on my computer? Will I be able to use these circuit things without limit? Or do I need to worry that I may be sacrificing performance of my factory? And the answer is, Factorio is really intelligent in how it does things. For example, these signals aren't changing, and therefore Factorio really doesn't calculate anything for them. And that's why you can use these things basically without limit. It's much more likely that another part of your factory causes much more performance drain than this whole circuit thing. And with that, I will conclude this technical detail. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and see you later!